So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's class guys, we'll be talking about the PIB news from 16th to 17th of February 2023, and there are some of the very important news today. So please listen to every question, every news, every word carefully. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question guys, which is about the second advance estimates of production of major crops for the agricultural year 2022-23. Yes, the second advance estimates of production of major crops for agriculture year 2022-23 has been released by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and this question is based on that. The question is about the new record production of moong. Okay, so let's talk about the second advance estimates, then we will come back to the question. So guys, in the advance estimates, you need to remember some of the most important estimates, right? For example, you need to remember about the food grains. You need to remember about the oil seeds overall. You need to remember about the sugar cane, etc., etc. And if there is any record production, okay? Like, for example, if I talk about food grains, so the second advance estimate says it will be 32.5454 lakh tons, right? And it is higher by 79.38 lakh million tons. ठीक है, now ये वाले जो चीजें हैं, rice, wheat, nutri core cereals, maize, barley, इसका अगर आप याद कर सकते हो तो then that is fine, otherwise it is not that important, but I would suggest you to learn at least the estimates of rice and wheat, right? Rice और wheat का at least आप लोग याद कर लो, that is something which is required for the examination, right? Now talking about pulses, so total pulses 278.10 lakh tons, and again you don't have to remember these data which are comparing with the previous years. Just remember the total production of pulses as per the second advance estimate, 278.10 lakh tons. And again, gram you don't have to remember, it is 136.32 lakh tons. However, you need to remember the estimates of moong, which is 35.45 lakh tons, because that is a new record production, right? So if there is any record production, you have to remember that, obviously, right? Now oil seeds ki baat karein, toh overall it is 400.01 lakh tons, and individually if I talk about groundnut, so it is 100.56 lakh ton, soya bean 139.75, rape seed and mustard it is 128.18 lakh tons, alright? And let's talk about sugar cane then. Sugar cane is important, 4687.89 lakh tons. Cotton 337.23 lakh bales of 170 kg each, and jute and mesta 100.49 lakh bales of 180 kg each, right? And if I am not wrong, last year in NABARD phase 1 there was a question on the this advance estimate. So advance estimates are very very important, especially for the NABARD examination, okay? So that is all about the estimates, and the question is regarding the new record production of moong, which is 35.45 lakh tons. Option B is the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 2 then. Which organization under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs will be organizing Adi Mahotsav, National Tribal Festival in New Delhi, to provide direct market access to tribal master craftsmen and women, right? कौन सी organization है that works under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs will be organizing this National Tribal Festival. So remember guys, it will be organized by TRIFED, right? It will be organized by TRIFED, and the objective will be to provide direct market access to the craftsmen. ठीक है, जो भी craftsmen और women है उनको direct market access provide करना, that is the basic objective of National Tribal Festival, which will be organized in Delhi, right? And where in Delhi? National Stadium, right? Major Dhyan Chand National Stadium में इसको organize कराया जाएगा, right? The theme will be a celebration of the spirit of tribal crafts, culture, cuisine and commerce. Nodal agency, as I told you, TRIFED. It will see the participation from more than 1,000 tribal artisans and artists from 28 cities or UTs, and there will be tribal freedom fighters gallery. It will be set up to showcase the stories of tribal freedom fighters. जो भी हमारे tribal freedom fighters हैं, उनकी story को showcase करने के लिए tribal freedom fighters gallery will be set up. ठीक है? So that is all, and therefore the correct answer is Tribal Cooperative Marketing Federation of India, which in short is TRIFED. Option D is the correct answer. All right, I hope this is clear, and now let's move ahead to question number 3. On which date of every month health melas will be organized in all 1.56 lakh Ayushman Bharat health and wellness centers across the country? एज पार्ट ऑफ ऑन गोइंग स्वस्थ मन स्वस्थ घर कैंपेन, राइट। किस डेट पे हेल्थ मेलाज ऑर्गेनाइज कराए जाएंगे एवरी मंथ? सो द डेट विल बी 14th, डेट विल बी 14th, हेल्थ मेलाज विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज एवरी मंथ इन ऑल दी आयुष्मान भारत हेल्थ एंड वेलनेस सेंटर एज पार्ट ऑफ स्वस्थ मन स्वस्थ घर कैंपेन। नाउ व्हाट विल बी, यू नो, व्हाट एक्टिविटीज विल टेक प्लेस इन दीज हेल्थ मेलाज? सो बेसिकली योगा, जुम्बा, टेली कंसल्टेशन, निक्षय पोषण अभियान, नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज स्क्रीनिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, सिकल सेल डिजीज स्क्रीनिंग, ऑल ऑफ दीज एक्टिविटीज विल बी अंडरटेकन अंडर द हेल्थ मेलाज ऑन 14th ऑफ एवरी मंथ इन ऑल दी आयुष्मान भारत हेल्थ एंड वेलनेस सेंटर्स। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस स्वस्थ मन स्वस्थ घर कैंपेन? So remember, it was launched last year in the month of November 2022 and it will be continued till October 2023. And basic objective is to promote the theme of health and wellness to commemorate the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, right? Ek saal ka campaign hoga, duration maine aapko bata diya. Ministry of course is the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. And this campaign is in line with the National Health Policy of 2017 which focuses on preventive and promotive healthcare. And also it is in line with Fit India Movement of 2019, which is aimed at making fitness and healthy living an integral part of our lives. All right. So that is all about it. So on which date health melas will be organized? So 14th of every month. Option C is the correct answer, guys. Moving ahead to question number 4. Again, very, very important question. Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana has been notified by Indian Railways to empower youth by providing them entry level skill training in railway training institutes. So which of the following statements are incorrect about this scheme? ठीक है, कौन सी स्टेटमेंट इनकरेक्ट है वो आपको बतानी है, बट बिफोर दैट लेट्स टॉक अबाउट रेल कौशल विकास योजना। सो एज द नेम सेज, रेल मींस ऑफ कोर्स रेलवेज, कौशल मींस व्हाट स्किल, एंड विकास मींस व्हाट डेवलपमेंट, विकास मींस व्हाट डेवलपमेंट। सो बेसिकली स्किल डेवलपमेंट इन दी रेल ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट इज द बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम। So the objective is to impart technical training in various trades to enhance employability and entrepreneurship of the youths. It is a skill development program, of course, under the very remarkable scheme of the Government of India, Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. It was launched 2 years back, 2021. And 100 hours training in the industry relevant trade is provided under this particular scheme. 100 hours, okay? Initially, the training was provided for 4 trades, that is electrician, welder, machinist and fitter, but based on the local needs, based on the regional demands, the zonal railways has started providing training in other sectors, in other trades as well, right? The training is currently being provided at 94 training locations, and in the upcoming 3 years, that is in the 3 years implementation of this particular scheme, the target is to train 50,000 candidates, right? 50,000 candidates ko train kara jayega. एलिजिबिलिटी की बात करें, सो रिमेंबर एनी मेट्रिकुलेशन पास्ट पर्सन हु इज बिटवीन द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 18 to 35 ईयर्स इज एलिजिबल, एंड देर इज नो एंट्रेंस टेस्ट, देर इज नो एलिजिबिलिटी टेस्ट, सो सिलेक्शन विल बी कंप्लीटली बेस्ड ऑन द मार्क्स ऑफ द मेट्रिकुलेशन। द ट्रेनिंग ऑफकोर्स इज फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट, क्योंकि अगर फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट नहीं होगी तो वाई वुड समवन गो टू टेक दिस ट्रेनिंग, राइट। द नोडल कोऑर्डिनेटिंग एजेंसी, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट, इज बनारस लोको वर्क्स, विच इज ऑफकोर्स इन वाराणसी, एंड रिमेंबर there is no provision of providing employment or stipend, right? Like for example, in National Apprenticeship Promotion Scheme or Training Scheme, we have certain amount of stipend which is being provided to the candidates. But here in this scheme, there is no provision for such kind of or any kind of stipend. Okay? So that is all about this. And let's identify the incorrect statement. It is a skill development program under the aegis of Pradhan Mantri Yuva Yojana. No, that's under Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. It was launched in 2022. No, this is incorrect. This is incorrect. Candidates with matriculation 10 pass and age 16 to 30. Is that so? No. The age group is 18 to 35. So this is also incorrect. Skill training under it is provided in more than 500 trades. No, more than 500 trades to nahi hai. Initially there were 4 and now some trades have been added because of regional demand. And there is provision of providing an employment and also stipend to trainees. No, there is no such provision. So every statement here is incorrect. All of the above is the correct answer. Option E. Moving ahead, guys, to question number 5. इंडिया हैज रिसेंटली होस्टेड स्पेशल नेगोशिएटिंग राउंड ऑफ इंडो पैसिफिक इकोनॉमिक फ्रेमवर्क फॉर प्रोस्पेरिटी इन न्यू दिल्ली. Which of the following pillars of IPEF were covered during this special negotiating round? Remember IPEF, first of all, remember this is not a free trade agreement. This is absolutely not a free trade agreement, and there are four pillars of IPEF, which are trade, supply chain, clean economy and fair economy. India is not a part of this pillar one. India is a part of pillar two, three and four. Okay? So it is in news because India has hosted the special negotiating round for Indo-Pacific Economic Framework for Prosperity, and as the name says, the objective of this framework is to maintain economic, social, political and every type of prosperity in the Indo-Pacific region, right? This special round covered three pillars, pillar 2, 3 and 4, which are supply chains, clean economy and fair economy, right? Now talking about Indo-Pacific Economic Framework for Prosperity, so as I told you, the objective is cooperation, stability, prosperity, development and peace within the Indo-Pacific region. It was launched last year and it was a brainchild of US President Joe Biden. And as I told you, it is not a free trade agreement. ठीक है, ये कोई free trade agreement नहीं है. It just seeks to advance resilience, sustainability, inclusiveness, economic growth, fairness, prosperity, peace, development, everything in the Indo-Pacific region. Alright? And there are 14 partners in IPEF from the Indo-Pacific region. These are the 14 partners which collectively represent 40% of the global GDP and 28% of global goods and services trade. And as I already told you, there are four pillars of IPEF, which are trade, supply chains, clean economy and fair economy. Okay? So that is all about this news. And now let's come back to the question. I already told you 2, 3 and 4 pillars. Ke baare mein ye special negotiating round tha. And therefore, option D is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 6. Identify incorrect statement about 14th edition of Aero India, which was recently inaugurated by Prime Minister Modi at Yelahanka Air Force Station in Bangalore. So this is important. Isme se question aa jata hai. First of all, you have to remember where did it take place. It took place in Yelahanka Air Force Station in Bangalore in Karnataka. And the sole objective was to showcase India's growth in aerospace and defense capabilities. Right? And now when we are talking about defense capabilities, it must be organized by Ministry of Defense, by an organization under Ministry of Defense, that is Defense Exhibition Organization. The theme was the runway to a billion opportunities. Okay? So that's all. Isse zyada nahi padhna. So it is Asia's biggest aero show being held at Yelahanka Air Force Station. Correct? It has been organized by Ministry of Heavy Industries. No. It was organized by Ministry of Defense. And all rest of the statements are clear because it took place in a total area of around 35,000 square kilometer, which is the biggest ever aero show tha till date. Alright. So option D is the correct answer. And let's move ahead to the very, very important question from today's session, that is about the Vibrant Villages program. I hope you guys remember in 22-23 budget, the finance minister announced this scheme, Vibrant Villages program, and now it has been approved by the Union Cabinet, right? So it is very, very important for the upcoming RBI Grade B examination and NABARD as well. So let's talk about Vibrant Villages program, then we will come back to the question. So Vibrant Villages is for the border villages. This program is for border villages, right? And under this program, the government will help border villages in achieving inclusive growth and retaining the population in the border areas. The duration will be from this financial year, that is financial year 23, to financial year 2026 till the end of the 15th finance commission period. Total financial allocation is 4800 crores, and out of which 2500 crores will be used for roads construction only, right? The ministry, very important, the ministry will be the Ministry of Home Affairs that will be implementing this scheme, and funds will be provided for development of essential infrastructure, and with the help of that, creation of livelihoods for the people living in the border villages and to hold them, thereby retaining the border population in their respective villages. Okay, taki wo migrate na kare. It will cover 19 districts and 46 border blocks of 4 border states, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim, and 1 UT, Ladakh. In first phase, it will cover 663 villages. And these are some of the key focus outcomes, like connectivity with all weather road, drinking water, 24/7 electricity through Sabhagya Yojana, drinking water through Jal Jeevan Mission, mobile and internet connectivity, through that Bharat something program, I'm forgetting the name, tourist center and multi-purpose center and health and wellness centers. Okay, so Bharat Net program, yes, that is Bharat Net program. So basically it will be a convergence of various schemes, and through all those schemes along with the funding, the border villages will be developed, so that there shall be inclusive development in the border villages, and the population there, उनके पास इतने livelihood opportunities हो कि वो वहां पे रुके, वो migrate ना करें. So that is all, and let's identify the incorrect statement. It is a centrally sponsored scheme to be implemented by Ministry of Home Affairs. Correct. It has total financial allocation of 4800 crores, out of which 2500 crore will be used for roads. Correct. It will be implemented in all districts of all bordering states. No, all bordering states are not covered. Option C is the correct answer, because that is the incorrect statement. All right. And now, guys, ये रह गया है. Vibrant Village Action Plan will be created by the district administration with the help of Gram Panchayat, which will help in identify and develop the economic drivers in those villages, right? And it will be implemented through hub and spoke model. Okay, now let's jump to the questions in short, which do not need much explanation. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join this Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. Let's talk about question number 8 then. What was the theme of Defense Minister's Conclave 2023, which took place on the sidelines of Aero India 2023 in Bangalore, Karnataka? Defense Minister's Conclave 2023 took place with the theme of shared prosperity through enhanced engagements in defense. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 9. Where will National Seminar cum Exhibition on Scope for Growth and Development of MSMEs be organized by Ministry of MSME to spread the awareness about the MSME schemes and motivate youth to take up entrepreneurship? So where will this seminar take place? So it will take place in Sindhudurg. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 10. Where has NTPC Limited organized Indian Power Stations 2023 International Operations and Maintenance Conference 2023 with the theme strategies for reliable and sustainable power generation in changing energy scenario? So remember, it took place in Chennai. Option E is the correct answer. No, I think it took place in Ranchi. If I'm not wrong, it took place in Ranchi. Okay? Option B, Ranchi, is the correct answer. What is the total share of export of MSME related products in all India export during the year 21-22? So the total, this is, guys, an important question, right? Very important question. So total export of MSME related products in all India export during the financial year 22 was a whooping 45.03%, which shows that MSMEs are growing. Question number 12. Which of the following are the only public steel manufacturing units functioning across country? Public steel manufacturing units ab do bachi hain keval, SAIL aur Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited. So option D is the correct answer, A and B. And guys, the last question for today. How many urban water transportation projects worth 1900 crore is Ministry of Port Shipping and Waterways financially supporting under the Sagar Mala program? So how many urban water transportation projects the ministry is supporting? So 51 projects is being supported by the ministry. Option E is the correct answer. Okay, so guys, that is all for today's session. And ye wala jo question tha, I believe main thoda sa confused ho raha hu. Question number 10 mein Ranchi hai ya Chennai hai? I believe Ranchi hi hai iska answer, but agar Ranchi nahi hoga to I will make the correction in the comment section. Theek hai, so please check the comment section. Agar रांची नहीं होगा तो, वैसे रांची ही है, आई एम 80-90% श्योर, बट अगर नहीं होगा तो आई विल मेक द करेक्शन. ठीक है, ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स इट फॉर टुडेज क्लास. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस एंड देयर एक्सप्लेनेशंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.